Hi, Out Late Foot Graders. It's Tuesday, so this must be Stephie, and I have a special guest here. My sister Stephanie, who's living here now. Nice. And so I thought both of us would do the video for this week. This week's question for June 20th to 26th is from Sid. And it's, what's your position on why we are the way we are? Be it gay, bi, trans, whatever. Some say genetic. Some say something happens in the womb, while others point to nurture or simple free will. As we come to our one-year mark for Out Late But Great, give us your best guess. If you can point to some supporting research, all the better. So I thought what I would do is both Stephanie and I will answer this. So I'll take a cut at it, and then I'm going to pass this along to Stephanie, let her introduce herself a little bit, and go from there.
Thanks, Stephanie. Let's get started on the video.
Yeah. Okie dokie. Research. So if you go look at Wikipedia, that's an easy, easy, simple one that everyone can do, right? So you wiki homosexuality, and it says it's not a mental disorder since 1975. And that's based upon a lot of studies that were done in 1948, mm-hmm. 51, 53, mm-hmm. and then follow-on studies in 76 and 81. All lesbian and gay folks that I know are among the nicest people that I know.
Aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
I agree. They are. I have never met one that wasn't.
Yeah. And certainly not in it as a choice. They're not lesbians and gays as a choice. Mm. For transsexuality, there's several studies that show that there's a difference between male and female brain structure. Mm-hmm. The most recent one that I'm aware of is a February 2011 study showing the difference in brain structure and distribution of white and gray cells. Mm-hmm. And they're distributed differently between the two genders. Mm-hmm. So there is a difference. Our standards of care for the transsexual community is governed by the thing called WPATH. Mm-hmm. And currently the version of that, you can download that as a PDF file.
You're talking about version 6.
Yeah, it's version 6 currently. Yeah. And version 7 is being worked on as we study. And it's likely that version 7 will pull transsexuals out of the same box that's transgenders and right. cross-dressers and different kinds of folks that are in right now.
Right.
So that will pull that out of the box and create a new classification for it as well. That's the expectation at present.
Right.
My views. Free will? Who on earth would go through the grief and pain that we go through?
Oh my gosh.
As free will. So, I don't believe that.
Yeah.
Nurture? I guess it's possible. Certainly is not, in my case, it's not. There was no such concept of that growing up and things like that. Yeah. I had to discover that on my own. So, I roll that out in my case.
Yeah.
Is it a womb issue? There are studies that show stress can cause the wrong physical organs to develop. So there's some studies there. Mm-hmm. Certainly, a lot of us are XXY kind of individuals. One could make a case that that's genetic. One could make a case that for genetics, no, it's not. Certainly in the case of being passed on type of genetics, no. There's no reason to believe that my progeny would be transsexual in nature, although I was. Yeah. There's no reason to believe that gays pass on gayness, lesbians pass on lesbianness, and things like that. So, indeed, there's none of that, although a genetic mix-up can occur. Normally, people are XX and XY, but what do you do about the XXY people? What are they?
So, no, I mean, yeah, there's, I mean, the genes, there's a mixture of the genes.
Yeah.
Okay, which nature handles on its own. Mm-hmm. But it has nothing to do with a gene or a specific gene that is passed down from one generation to the other.
Right.
Which would be what we would call genetics. And genetics, it's just, there's nothing that's ever shown that what I am and what Steffi is would be passed down through our siblings, or that we had in fact have been passed down from our own parents as siblings of our parents,
right,
who were neither. There's no genetic study of that happening. So.
Right. So that's so from my viewpoint, that's the quick summary. Womb, free will, nurture, whatever. And so that's some of the research studies that I have. So I'm going to pass this along to Stephenie now. Let her introduce herself and all that sort of good stuff. Hey, Jim from Ohio. She's from Ohio.
Yes, I am. And also probably a fellow scientist, but in any case. Yeah, I had to look this over, and believe me, I can tell you that Steffi and I have shared hours of discussion on this topic prior to we have. And as fellow scientists, because she's a scientist on one spectrum, and I am on the on the human engineering programming spectrum, having worked with. The genetics practically all my entire life, just dabbling in her field, which is electronics, amongst other things, sensory. But in any case, I can tell you that I have some issues regarding some of the people's concepts of how things could or could not be developed. I'm with Stephenie 100%. There are no studies. There's nothing that's ever shown that anything is ever passed down from the gene pool. And believe me, I have children who have gone, oh my gosh, could my children have what you have? And scared to death that in fact could happen. What happened to me could happen to one of their kids, or they could pass it down. No. I'm sorry. We'll stop that right there. It's not going to happen. Okay, there is no such thing. You cannot pass down being gay from one generation to the other, nor can you pass down being bisexual, nor can you pass down being transsexual. It's just not possible. It cannot happen. Nature decides. That's how that happens.
Mm-hmm.
So when it comes down to that, now you know one of the other things that I'm going to go ahead and add, because I've taught this for an awful long time. You know, in our gender pools or our gender arenas, you know, we have a history of defining ourselves or labeling ourselves, okay, which helps us in defining ourselves as to what we are. And, you know, without that definition, who could say? And who makes this decision as to what definition is correct or which definition is incorrect? It's only done through study, through research, and finding the physical evidences, which can be now done genetically. Okay, you know, if modern science itself was not so busy trying to prove to us or trying to persuade us that we evolved from monkeys, gorillas, and apes, then perhaps society itself would be a lot more perceptive to learning the many facts of how nature indeed has provided a natural variety of mixed characteristics between all of us, and the individual as far as a singular and or a combination thereof. And that combination could be one side, could be on the other side, could be right smack dab in the middle and unidentifiable regarding both male and female. But both have to exist in order to create one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it has to be there. Given choice, none of us have that. A person who is gay or lesbian doesn't make a choice. They just gain conscious awareness of themselves, of what it is that they, in fact, is what appeals to them, what feels right to them, and what feels wrong to them. Okay, so when you take a look at that in the broader spectrum, this is not something that is something that happened that freaked the mother out while she was pregnant and you acquired due to a upset in the balance of the emotional characteristics of your parent. I don't think that happens neither. I think nature does make a lot of this. I mean, yeah, I do know that we can induce drugs, chemicals into our bodies and stuff like that, which could be very damaging to the fetus. Something like that, in fact, could happen. Something like that, in fact, could be traded off between the parent and the fetus. But I don't think that's what happens to any of us who are gay. I don't think that's what happens to those of us who are transsexual. There is no physical evidence to show any of that. So, you know, in my point of view regarding us as being transsexual, bisexual, gays, lesbians, are most of those who are defined not by profession in the transgender categories, we are of natural ascension, not of regression, and I don't think that it's more patternistic. There are things that say and things that show that, in fact, as you've seen, you know, where things can say, oh my gosh, you know, I tried that, I really liked it. You know, much like acquiring the taste of a good scotch. You know, first time I tried that, I'm going, oh my god, this is awful. Who wants to drink all of this stuff? But, you know, and you get to where, you know whether or not it fits you naturally. And you get to where you know who you are. There are those of us who have got so much that go on in our heads that we don't truly understand what it is that is different about us.
Mm-hmm.
But we know that we're different.
Yep.
Okay, it's that discovery of what is different that comes later on in life. Not the discovery of the fact that you are.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? You have that feeling. And I think you have that feeling kind of from the beginning. Mm-hmm. That you're something else. Or that something it doesn't fit. I think I found that in most characteristics. So, I'm going to sum that up because I have some other things that we're going to get into here. But let Stephanie go ahead and spew off and get some of her, what she's thinking out too as well. Because, you know, this is a large topic to talk about. And we have all of us that need to be supporting each other. We cannot do it alone. A gay cannot make it on their own without everyone else supporting them. And the same thing goes with all of us. That's why we have the LGBT community. And now we have the LGBT and what I classify as being the out-of-the-box world of transsexuality. Because that's where I fit. So, Stephanie.
Okie dokie. Well, thank you, folks, and I hope this has been entertaining for you. So you get a couple of viewpoints here.
Yeah.
And hopefully this was entertaining for you, and hopefully you also have some responses here as well.
Mm-hmm.
So what's your views on this? Leave us some comments down there. You just get down there. Whoops, get down there and make some comments.
Yeah.
And away you go. So, thanks, folks. And until next week, this is Stephanie.
And Stephanie.
Saying bye-bye.
Bye-bye.